There are two types of patterns in technical analysis. There are continuation patterns, and then of course, there are reversal patterns. So the first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna focus on individual patterns that we see quite frequently that are very continuation in nature. And I don't want you to stress over the names of these patterns. They have clever, funny names. It's more so the implications of the resolutions of these price patterns that we're most concerned with. Remember, markets by definition trend. So if we're in an uptrend, these consolidations, these digestions of gains are, there's a much higher likelihood that they will resolve higher rather than just completely reversing. So one of the more popular ones is the symmetrical triangle. So here we have a prior uptrend in place and then a consolidation over time where the market is essentially digesting those gains. Nothing goes straight up, but in an uptrend, you have sideways consolidations. One of them is a symmetrical triangle where prices are consolidating within converging trend lines. We expect to see a resolution out of that somewhere between 2/3 and 3/4 of the way to the apex. So in this case, breaking out and resolving higher in the direction of the prior trend. This is normal, this is typical, this is what we should come to expect out of these patterns. Similar to the symmetrical triangle, here we have a descending triangle. The only difference is, rather than two converging trend lines, we have a downtrend line that is the upper boundary of the consolidation, and then we have a flat horizontal trend line that is the lower boundary of that consolidation. So here we have a prior uptrend, a digestion of those gains, and again, that resolution should come somewhere between 2/3 and 3/4 towards the apex. And then finally, of these three triangles, the ascending triangle is very popular. We see it a lot, particularly in some of the healthiest and strongest markets. Again, like the symmetrical triangle, there are two converging trend lines. In this case, you have the uptrend line, which defines the lower boundary of this consolidation, and then you have the flat resistance, that overhead supply that defines the upper end of this range. What I want you to notice in these ascending triangles, and the reason why we find them in some of the most bullish markets, is because with each sell-off, notice how the higher lows are coming into play. That is the market signaling to us that the buyers, the demand in the market, these guys are getting more and more anxious with each decline. They're stepping back into the market a lot quicker. And it comes a point where the more times a level is tested, the higher the likelihood that it breaks, and we get the upside resolution and the continuation of the prior trend. That's why we call them continuation patterns. We talked about the uptrends and these consolidations within uptrends, but we see the exact same thing in downtrends. Just flip the chart upside down. Here we have a prior downtrend, a symmetrical triangle where prices are digesting those losses in between two converging trend lines. And then of course, this is a continuation pattern. So we should expect a downside resolution out of this pattern. So from a prior downtrend comes the digestion between two converging trend lines and then the ultimate resolution down. Now, when we have a downtrend, oftentimes these triangles, just like in uptrends, will be symmetrical triangles, ascending triangles, descending triangles. Here we have an ascending triangle within a downtrend, and then as soon as the lower boundary gets breached, the lower end of this range gets broken, it signals to us that the downtrend that came prior to this consolidation is now resuming to the downside. Rectangles are also very common, not as much as triangles because resistance and support needs to be very clean for it to be a rectangle. But again, the names of these patterns are less important. It's the implications that we're looking for. And just like triangles, these rectangles are consolidations within the underlying trend. Here we have a downtrend line, consolidations in between two parallel trend lines rather than converging ones. And then once the lower boundary gets breached, that is a signal to us that the downtrend is now resuming. Now let's talk about the wedges. These are the same implications of the triangles and the rectangles. They are continuation in nature. They just have a different name because they're both trending counter to price. So rather than having a symmetrical triangle where these two trend lines are converging, or you have an ascending triangle or a descending triangle, in this case, both trend lines are declining. They are going counter to trend, but the implications are the same, guys. So you have a prior uptrend, you have prices in a falling wedge between two converging downtrend lines, and then of course the upside resolution, as usual, normally comes somewhere between 2/3 and 3/4 of the way to the apex. Here we have a rising wedge within a downtrend, where once the lower boundary is broken, now you have the continuation of the prior downtrend. Notice how these wedges are always going counter to the direction of the market. In this case, we had a prior downtrend. So these two converging trend lines are both upward trending. And then once the lower end is breached, again, somewhere between 2/3 and 3/4 of the way to the apex, that is evidence that the trend is now ready to continue, in this case, to the downside. Now, a lot of these triangles and rectangles and wedges, they take a long time to develop. But in some of the strongest trends, these are very quick, short patterns that don't take very long to resolve. Here we're looking at a pennant. We have a beautiful uptrend, a nice digestion of gains, not necessarily as long or as time consuming as some of these symmetrical triangles that we looked at. This is short, quick, sweet, to the point. And then once we get a breakout above the upper end of the range, that signals to us that the uptrend is now ready to continue. Flags are the exact same thing as a pennant. But in a pennant, it's kind of a symmetrical triangle where the trend lines are converging. In the case of a flag, they are parallel trend lines counter to the trend. So in this case, we have an uptrend, a nice little digestion of those gains, and then the continuation once we breach the upper end of that range.